Everybody, welcome to the Void's YouTube channel. We're here on Tuesday, March 6th. Weather's rainy, it's not gonna keep us from brewing. Whatever you're doing today, if you're having a bad day, maybe you're having a good day, let's make it a better day. We're gonna brew some beer, drop what you're doing. It's about to happen. About to get with the guys. Vlad's making breakfast right now. Brian's, I think, working on that. We got our buddy Riley over here today, and we're gonna be working on a stout, a peanut butter stout today. So it's a first for the company. We're really excited to try it, actually. So thanks for coming with us on the journey. Let's do it.
Oh, shit, sweet. This is gonna
take a stir the grain.
Yes.
Do it for the grain.
Vlad, what's you doing?
It got darker.
It got dark. It got darker.
Yeah. No, I was just regulating the flow for the circulation as it comes out of the chiller. So a little bit slower just to help cool it down, or a degree over our target mass temp right now. The cool thing is that it looks like dark motor oil.
It's beautiful. Wow.
Yeah, 5W peanut butter.
That's actually a good name.
Yeah, that's 5W peanut butter.
No, did we just do that?
Peanut butter W30.
You peanut butter PBW30?
Right.
Either one works, I like both.
You guys heard it first.
We should do like PBW30.
No, it's even more stupid,
it's
peanut butter W30. Because it's not abbreviated, it's weird. I like it.
I like the name, I mean, I couldn't think of anything better myself, honestly.
I like five.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, this has a little scoop in there. Let's make sure that wasn't getting on the beer. Oh, peanut butter dust all on my body.
Pounds are going to be put into secondary for dry hop with some cacao nibs.
Copy.
Chocolate peanut butter Reese cup.
On the way. No. Well, what just broke?
Yeah. There's a sight glass that shows you the level without having to open the kettle up. Right here. And,
sorry, bike.
And it's supposed to come with a stainless steel guard that shows you not only the volume reading, but also to protect the glass itself. When we got our setup, out of everything it comes with, it's an honest, simple mistake, where they forgot to package that one guard for this kettle. And so dumping the grains after our last brew, shattered it.
Yeah. That's what that was. When I asked you if that was just a false bottom that made that noise?
Yeah.
It was a sight glass.
Yeah. Piece one.
Piece two.
And as you can tell, those other two kettles right there, it has a guard going all the way around it.
Yeah, the stainless. Yeah, look at that.
To protect it.
Whereas that was just.
I mean, you know, with the guard on there. Like,
this right here. This was bare glass the whole time. Just kind of broke. Well, dang it, man.
Still had a great brew day. It cut us short. We were gonna make a goza. But no, we can't.
Which we still can. I mean, we stopped everything for the goza, so next brew day we'll just knock it out.
Yeah.
It's been a pretty good day, so.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah, cool.
We came up with a name about it a little over a year ago, and we found out that there was another guy that we saw on Facebook who called himself Fifth Element Brewing, just like ours, but spelled the number 5, T-H, Element Brewing, rather than F-I-F-T-H, Element Brewing. So we didn't think it was an issue.
Yeah, and then we ended up trying to look into trademarking our name, so we did some research and figured out that he had actually trademarked it about a month ago, which kind of hurt our feelings a little bit. But we really just looked at it as an opportunity. You know, obviously if there's already somebody out there that's got Fifth Element Brewing as a name, we wouldn't want to A, take it away from them, obviously, since they're trademarked and run into issues, you know, later on down the road. And B, obviously, even if it wasn't an issue, we wouldn't want that to be our name, just because obviously we want to be unique and do our own thing. So we ended up kind of thinking about it and coming up with a new name, which took some thought. But it, you know, it makes sense, and there's kind of a story behind it, so I'll let Brian tell you what the name is.
So we kind of came up with Fifth Element Brewing before as obviously the Fifth Element beer. But it's kind of tied into Philosopher's Stone. And in addition to that, we came up with the name The Void because the Japanese historically, they're Fifth Element. So they have water, earth, fire, and wind, and void. Where in other parts of the world, it was ether or aether, which was the Fifth Element, also referred to as the Philosopher's Stone as well. So it actually kind of means exactly the same thing and ties into the same business model, the same image, exactly what we were trying to accomplish to begin with when we came up with the Fifth Element. And so nothing's changed. It's just more unique and don't have to worry about the confusion or anything being too similar and taking that away from someone else.
Right. Well, then obviously with The Void, we feel like beer is special to us anyway, and obviously to a bunch of other people. So, you know, we want to use beer to, you know, create friendships and relationships and just be an overall good social lubricant. Obviously, just help it, you know, fill the void. If you have a rough day, you go home and have a nice craft beer. I don't advocate drinking when you're upset heavily. Obviously, it certainly helps and helps put you in a better mood. So cheers to that and fill the void.
Absolutely.
All right, guys, I think that's it for the day. So take it easy. Cheers.
See you next time.
Fill that void.
Jesse Bell.
Yeah.
Hey.